When you come home from a shoot and you have a nice photo, the only problem is you blew out the highlights. It can really kill the mood because, you know, we like to say that, you know, if your highlights are blown out, it's ruined. You know, you cannot do anything with it. It's not entirely true. There is actually, well, in some cases, it is possible to rescue those photos. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to take this and rescue it so it looks like this. And to do that, we're going to start in Lightroom and then go to Photoshop. So let's dive in. So here we have our photo. This is the photo I'm going to edit, and you see, it is a nice photo. It's you know, it's what I like the most about this. It's like the ads light around the guy. It's I do like this photo. It has this problem that these highlights here in the sky, they are blown out. Could I have done anything differently? No. Well, When you're shooting straight into the sun, the difference between the dark and the darkest area and the lightest area, it's just too big. It doesn't matter what kind of a camera you have, the dynamic range isn't gonna do it. So what you could do, for example, what I do in landscape shots, I bracket. But here I have a fisherman which is moving, the boats are moving, so it's gonna be challenging. I could have taken a shot for the sky. That's gonna be really dark. But so, and also if I expose for the highlights, which I normally would advise people to do, the fisherman is gonna be just black. Yeah, there's no detail. Like I have no details in it. Although it's gonna be a silhouette, I don't want it to be a black silhouette. I don't like that. So let's see what we can do to save this photo. First, I'm gonna do just basic editing stuff I always do. I'm not gonna spend much time in explaining this, but if you're completely new to Lightroom and you want to learn the basic, I made a whole course for Lightroom where you start in the beginning, where you import the photo until you edit them and doing some advanced stuff. It's hours of material. It's free. The link is in the descriptions, and feel free to check that out. But here I'm gonna do this. This is chromatic aberration, just to get rid of any, sometimes in the contrasty area you see pink or green lines. I don't want that. And profile corrections, which come, especially when you're shooting with a wide angle lens, which this is actually not. It corrects, if it's somewhat skewed or something. Usually you will see it mostly in vignetting in the corners, like you can see here. But enough about that. Then I'm going to, look at the highlights. You know, say what I can save. If I drag down my highlights slide, you can see there's not a lot I can say. I mean, you can see the more I drag it down, it just looks ugly. It just looks gray and ugly. So I don't want to do that too much. A little bit. And drag the exposure a little bit down. And I also want to adjust the tone curve. I want to make a nice S curve. Maybe I would just put one in the middle before, so I can only affect the shadows here and only affect the highlights here. Look at when I drag up the highlights, how the glow on the hat looks really nice like that. I like that. All right. So I'm gonna lift the shadows a little bit. Not that much. But also I want to darken the blacks. Something like that. So right now I'm just gonna go into Photoshop. So I right click on my photo and select edit in Adobe Photoshop. There is one more tool I use for this, which is not included in Photoshop, because this is all about selection. I need to be able to select the area I want to deal with. That's all, you know, that's what editing is about. You select an area, you do something with that area. So to select an area like this, there is a tool called, there's a thing called Luminosity Mask. Luminosity Mask, which basically means it selects area based on its luminosity. So there is a way is to do stuff like that in Photoshop, but it's kind of like, I don't do it. I use a luminosity panel. What I use is TK panel, Tony Cooper panel, something like that. It's very good, it's cheap. The link is in the description. If you don't have TK panel, but you have some other panel, like other luminosity mask tool, you can use that. You know, it doesn't matter which one you have, they all work. They all work basically the same. So let's look at that. Here I got my TK panel, and I'm gonna duplicate my layer so I have something to fall back on. And this is not even the most recent version, I think, of TK, but it's a pretty good one. Here, in this area here, I'm dealing with my highlights. On this side, I'm dealing with the shadows, and here is the midtones. So, I'm gonna be dealing with the highlights, since it's the highlights we're trying to fix here, and there is no, like, magic number here. You know, I'm just gonna select, let's select three, something like that. Look at that. So, black is not selected, white is selected. This is too much, so I'm going 5. It looks like 5 is too small. Yeah, I think that's it. Let's go with 4. We can always come back to this and change it if we need. So, here I'm gonna click in output. I'm gonna click selection. It just does what it says it does. It just selects the luminosity I asked the computer to do. So, what next? Now, basically what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna paint this white area here. So I need a color for that. So I use my eyedropper tool to pick a color. You know, if I pick, for example, let's pick too dark. Then I use the brush and I just paint the color in. Okay, look at this. It's better, but it's just yellow. It's, you know, it's there is no I don't like that. So like I said, it was too dark. So I'm gonna undo that, and I'm gonna pick the eyedropper tool again. I don't want to go too light either. So let's try something like that. Then paint over again. This looks much nicer. Like here. Let's deselect Command D. And maybe it's a tad too much. So then I would just use the opacity. Select the layer and choose the opacity to dial that down a little bit to get, you know, the structure back. The little structure we had, we don't want to lose that. So, when I'm happy with that, I'm just gonna right click on either layer and flatten image. We don't need these layers anymore. File and save. And then what Photoshop does, it, you know, saves the photo and throws it back as a new photo in Lightroom. So here we have it. This is what we threw in Photoshop. And this is what we got back. So, like I said, sometimes when you look at this photo, you can see the sun is behind him, it's blown out. It's like it's basically like it should be, but I don't like to have white areas like that in my photos. I like to soften that out. Any more than I like to have black areas in my photos. I don't like that either. I usually wash out a little bit the black colors. So here we are with this. There's not much really I need to do here. I want to crop it a little bit. I feel like the space here on the right is a bit too much. So I'm going to change the aspect to 5.5, 5.7 and something like that. Yeah, that's nice. So then we have some, if you want to do some minor adjustments, you can do that now. This is my workflow. I open my photos always in Lightroom. I edit it there. So Lightroom is my go-to software. If I need something more like this, like luminosity masking, if I need to clone out something big, stuff like that, I throw it into Photoshop, I throw it back into Lightroom, then I do my final adjustments there, and then I export from there. I'm looking for this soft, nice look, like you can see here, and very often I will put a minus value on clarity rather than add clarity. I find it completely overused. And the thing is, if you see a photo from someone, it's a nice photo, you can see the clarity. It's very easy to spot it if it's overused. So if you can see the clarity, my opinion, it's too much. So, you know, if you can see what somebody did to the photo, it's too much. Yeah, but you know, do what you want. This is how I do it. Also, I might do a little vignetting here, just to frame it a little bit. Try also with that, if I do too much, you can see the edges, they just darken too much, they look crappy, you know. Just a little bit, just to frame it a little bit. So, I hope you enjoyed this. This is how I save these kind of images, if I happen to blow out the highlights in an area like this, where especially when I'm shooting in the sun, I'm not too worried about it because I can always do that. And it's fairly easy to do. It requires luminosity masks, and it is possible to do that in Photoshop, but it's very clumsy. I don't like it. I like the third-party panels, all of them. Most of them are really good. I got TK panel because somebody said this is a nice panel, so I just got that, you know. But I tried many others, they basically all work the same, they're all very good. But if you want to take a look at it, there's a link in the description to that panel. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and hope you are able to do this with your own photos. Thank you for watching and goodbye.